everybody. So I just wanted to share with you really quick my thoughts on Hotel Transylvania 3. I was able to see it yesterday in advanced screening, and I really enjoyed it. I think that all of these movies have been fine. Like, none of them are going to be nominated for Oscars or be amazing films, but I think they've all had some pretty good laughs, and they've all been pretty well animated by director Genndy Tartakovsky. And I think that this is better than the last one, I can say. The second one had some good things about it, but I thought it didn't use its secondary characters very well. I didn't think it used Vlad very well. I didn't think it used any of the other ensembles very well, and I did not like the ending. I thought it was kind of a cop-out to make the little boy a vampire in the end. Like, it would have been more interesting if they would have had to adapt to somebody who was truly different, I think. And yeah, but other than that, it was still fun. Like, these movies are fine. I don't think they're terrible. And I think that this one has really pretty animation. I particularly liked any time that you see the ship, it just looked sparkling. It looked beautiful. And it had some of that hybrid animation that I like from the Peanuts movie, where it's like everything looks kind of flat and layered, but it's still CG. And I think that that was nice to see. I think that it had some pretty funny jokes. There's a joke, particularly at the end, involving music that really made me laugh. And I thought that they did a better job in this film of using the ensemble. I particularly liked to see Fran Drescher getting a few more lines as Eunice, because she's one of my favorites. I love Fran Drescher. But all of the supporting characters, Frankenstein and the Invisible Man, and there was a really funny like little thing with the werewolves, and they're like tons of kids, and they like the daycare on the ship is like, yeah, we'll take care of your kids so you can enjoy the day. And they're like, what? No, what? And I'm sure that most parents will be able to relate to that. It was pretty funny, I thought. And overall, I mean, the thing that doesn't work in this movie is there's just a completely unnecessary villain. Like, it would have been like plenty of plot, I think, for them to go on this cruise and for Drac to fall in love and for Mavis to have a problem with it and have to deal with it. Like, that's enough story. We don't need this like over the top villain. I don't think that part worked really very well, but the action is animated well. Everything's animated well. And I thought the music was fun. I enjoyed it. If you're just looking for an entertaining way to get out of the heat, then this is good. It's not as good as Incredibles 2 or like, I don't know, some other movie, but I think that it's a solid, entertaining animated film. I'd give it a smile-worthy, probably give it like a B. It's not like a great movie, but it's enjoyable. It's entertaining. So that's what I think. And thanks so much. Please subscribe to my channel. I'll talk to you later. Bye.